Kyrsten Sinema is so aggressively condescending towards her voters, towards reporters, towards the country, that I feel like it really is going to break through. And I have a couple pieces of evidence of that. But I do want to point out the hypocrisy, because I have said one of the things that bothers me more about her is I feel like she's more dishonest than Manchin. Manchin sucks and he's never claimed not to. Whereas Sinema has implied that she actually gives a damn about people and clearly doesn't. So you probably know that she has told Senate Democratic colleagues that she's not okay with literally any increase in corporate or individual tax rates for the wealthiest people in the country. Literally anything. A more extreme position than literally some Republicans in the Senate. Of course, way back in 2011, she tweeted asking big corporations and the rich to pay their fair share is common sense, not class warfare. But then the class warfare, I guess, happened and lobbyists appealed to her and they won that battle. And so now she doesn't hold that position anymore. At one point, there's this tweet, corporations spend in secret to influence Congress and rig the game. Yep, they do. And they got you. They got you, Sinema. You pointed it out and then they got you. It's like something out of a horror movie, I guess. But the condescension is even worse. So she was asked by Frank Thorpe, who I think works for NBC News, what do you say to progressives who are frustrated when they don't know where you are? And she said, I'm in the Senate. He said, there are progressives in the Senate that are also frustrated that they don't know where you are either. And she said, I'm clearly right in front of the elevator. Which is a longer version of just giving a double middle finger to all of her colleagues, all of her voters who are suffering. She doesn't care at all. And the evidence that I have a little bit of it starting to break through is there was this interaction between Don Lemon and Chris Cuomo. I want to play that for you now.
What's happening in Washington? You know, you have the Democrats. They're making their own problems. We're going out of our way to do it in this society.
Well,
right,
it's
now.
Not necessarily. Well, Democrats, yes. But you also have two Republicans in the Democratic Party who are making problems for the Democrats, and that's Manchin and Sinema.
That's your opinion.
No, that they are Republicans. Come on.
No, that's your opinion. They're both Democrats.
That's not an opinion. Just look at the way
they are
vote.
Both Democrats. Yeah. There's a D after their name. That's the fact.
Yeah. Okay. All right, that's
no. I don't let it get in the way of your opinion.
No, no.
I don't want you to be burdened by that. I'm sorry. I shouldn't even have brought it up.
I see them as Republicans. So maybe maybe you're right. I see them as Republicans. They're acting as Republicans.
All right.
All right. But listen.
And I see you as cheap. But I love you, D. Lemon.
I don't get the cheap thing. I guess I don't watch. Maybe it's a reference to something. But the fact that they technically are Democrats, of course, does not rebut the point that Don Lemon is making. Is that in their actual actions, they represent the exact same interests and they hold many of the same positions as Republicans. I think that's the point he's making. I'm surprised to see Don Lemon making that point. I don't think of Don Lemon as any kind of like massive progressive or anything like that. But I love them pointing out that this is not about like Pramila Jayapal, like is screwing over Biden by threatening to vote down the bipartisan bill or AOC or Tlaib or Omar or anyone. This is about the two Republican Democrats. And I'm glad to see that on a network like CNN.
Yeah, I loved this moment. I completely agree with Don Lemon here. And I think you're right. I think that we're starting to see this kind of breakthrough and people say like, oh, wait, it's these two, right? Like they're the ones standing in front of the progress. And so I completely agree. And I loved that little moment. I think they may be, you know, Democrats in name. There might be a comma D at the end of their name, but they are Republicans for all intents and purposes.
Yeah. Now, that is not to say that everyone is acknowledging the position that these two senators hold. I was reading this article in the New York Times and I read a line that just flames on the side of my face. And it was in an article that was pointing out how frustrated many voters in Arizona are with Sinema. And this is the line. A breakthrough on the legislation could quell much of the criticism and burnish Mrs. Sinema's image as a deal maker who shepherded a related bipartisan infrastructure bill through the Senate. That sentence is absolute dog crap. When you stand against something and let's say it somehow still passes over your obstruction, weaker because of the effect you had on it, you were not a deal maker. You stopped it briefly and you made it worse and yet it still happened. No. A deal maker gets something through that otherwise wouldn't. Like if we, which is, there's lots of people and nobody could agree, but she came together and she brought the, no, she's the obstacle. What the, that's the New York Times saying that. That is just Sinema campaign PR that they're saying for her in an article that acknowledges how many of her former supporters feel fundamentally betrayed by her. They're doing PR for her. There's more to it. It's a frustrating article. Look it up. Helium to Cochrane in the New York Times if you want, but so frustrating. Anyway, any final thoughts on Sinema Manchin and the infrastructure process?
Yeah, they are bad people.
That's really it.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.